some goldfish. They swim around all day. Just two small floating goldfish. They very seldom play. But we have some very nice goldfish. One is red and one is white. They swim around in the daytime, and they hunker down at night. I wouldn't like to be a goldfish, a swimming in the bowl. You're at the mercy of the elements. You're warm when it's warm, and you're cold when it's cold. But we have some very nice goldfish. One is red and one is white. They swim around in the daytime, and they hunker down at night. I wouldn't like to be a goldfish, a swimming in the bowl. You're at the mercy of the elements. You're warm when it's warm, and you're cold when it's cold. But we have some very nice goldfish. One is red and one is white. They swim around in the daytime, and they hunker down at night. Oh, think of how the rattlesnake upon its belly glides, and marvel at the tracks it makes while jogging side to side. Or starts a rhythm with its tail, a warning sound it gives, to leave at once and without fail if you would wish to live. And how it can consume a meal much wider than its maw. To take a mouse with mute appeal must dislocate its jaw. It's then the snake may rest for days while she digests her food. And deep within a darkened way, it's there she'll raise a brood. Of how the rattlesnake upon its belly glides, and marvel at the tracks it makes while jogging side to side. Though I'm convinced you're fine and swell and marvelous to see, please understand me when I yell, snake, get away from, get away from, get away from me. How does the little bumblebee on many errands flit? It seems from each gold buttercup he takes a little bit. He works each waking moment, many errands he must do, with pollen on each hairy leg like drops of golden dew. His wings they flutter wildly, much faster than my eye. If only he could know it, he's not supposed to fly. He rides the long bright sunbeams, plays Cupid to the flowers, visits multicolored haunts, knows nature's hidden bowers. He has his armor in his tail, his stinger sharp and pointed, can cause some strong men's hearts to fail with venom once anointed. So marvelous a creature, quite intelligent, I suppose. If only he could know my speech, I'd say, get off my nose. How does the little bumblebee on many errands flit? It seems from each gold buttercup he takes a little bit. He works each waking moment, many errands he must do, with pollen on each hairy leg like drops of golden dew. His wings they flutter wildly, much faster than my eye. If only he could know it, he's not supposed to fly. He rides the long bright sunbeams, plays Cupid to the flowers, visits multicolored haunts, knows nature's hidden bowers. He has his armor in his tail, his stinger sharp and pointed, can cause some strong men's hearts to fail with venom once anointed. So marvelous a creature, quite intelligent, I suppose. If only he could know my speech, I'd say, get off my nose.
Cat. First he occupies your lap, then he climbs up on your chest. I really think he's quite a pest. As you are reading in your chair, he'll hurl himself from anywhere. He often helps my head grow bald. I haven't told you about his claws. His claws, I wish you would, oh, that he keep them in their hoods. But no, I think his sheets are broken, the slashy gash is just a token. Don't try to sleep with him in bed while restful thoughts course through your head. For as he stretches every joint, he'll make quite sure you get his points. My daughter's cat is Siamese, this gives him license to be pleased by lowly ones like you and me. He's on a lofty plane, you see, he thinks there's royalty in him. We must count out to every whim, and though I like my daughter's cat, I have a word for him, it's scat. My My daughter's cat is Siamese. This gives him license to be pleased by lowly ones like you and me. He's on a lofty plane, you see. He thinks there's royalty in him. We must kowtow to every whim. And though I like my daughter's cat, I have a word for him. It's scat!